MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 5 of the American League Division Series between the Minnesota Twins and the Houston Astros. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, this is still anyone's series here as we get ready for Game 5.
And guys, I'm going to be sorry to see this series come to an end. You've got to love a series that comes down to the final game. And seeing the push and pull struggle between these two teams over the last four games has been a lot of fun. We're in for a great one here in Game 5.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Christian Javier gets the call in Game 5 of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, Matt, you hate to go into game thinking that you're going to have to get the bullpen involved, but you may have to with this guy on the mound. He's not known for going very deep into games. Very rarely does he go six innings or more. So this very well could be one of those Johnny Holstaff days.
Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. And we are set for baseball here this evening. Just hung in there on that one. Very mild temperatures as we begin tonight. 58 degrees here at first pitch. Another 1-2. Oh, they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. 1-2, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good, hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
So now to the plate, Luis Arraez. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Bases are empty, one man. Breaks is bad as this one's popped up. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two.
That is third. The third baseman, Donaldson.
Next to dig in, Josh Donaldson. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit. Some two-out success to keep the top of the first alive.
Hey, there's a nice knock by the three-hole hitter. I know there's two outs, but they always say with your man coming up, the number four-hole monster, as soon as he steps in the batter's box, there's a runner in scoring position.
At the plate, Nelson Cruz. And that's taken up and in for ball two. He's fouling behind now, 3-1. Miguel Sano would be next. Two out base runner aboard in the top of the first. To third. Bregman gloves it. On to Altuve for the force out, and the inning is over. One left for Minnesota. And now the Astros will go to work for the first time. No score. Kenta Maeda will do the pitching in hostile territory here in Game 5. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Kenta Maeda, you're going to see a lot of off-speed pitches from Maeda. 88 to 91 miles an hour, not a terrific fastball. Good split finger, good slider. He's one of those guys that pitches backwards. What do I mean by that, Matt? He'll throw fastballs in breaking ball situations, and he'll throw off-speed pitches when he's behind the count. 2-0 or 2-1, he pitches backwards.
into the windup and the pitch. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there. It's 3-1 now.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1. It's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Pops this one up. And he'll put this one away for the first out of the inning.
Batting second, the third baseman, Alex Bregman.
So now into the box is Alex Bregman. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes. And the slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Now the pitch.
And this is where he's especially dangerous, because if you walk him, he can steal a base on you. But if you lay a fastball in there, he can take you deep, too.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Garlic will wait on it. And there's the second out of the inning.
That is good.
And with two away now, let's have a look at our playoff tree. And as you can see, the winner of this series faces a stern test ahead, with the evil empire, the New York Yankees, waiting for the winner in the ALCS. And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Pitch on the way. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's a drive out toward left center field. Brantley will take the turn and head for second now. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
When you drive the ball into the gap like that, nothing but good things can happen. Neither one of the outfielders had the wheels to catch up to it, and he glides easily into second for a double. Now we'll see if the guys behind him can get him in.
To the plate now, Carlos Correa, hit in the air down the right field line. Heading after it is Kepler. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. More on tap from Game 5 after this. Here's Miguel Sano. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Leading off the inning, your job is to get on base and set the table for the inning. That was a pretty good at bat, that he pushed the count to 3-2 and made the pitcher work. But I think he'd like to have that 3-2 pitch back. Pretty sure that was ball four he went after.
Into the box, Kyle Garlic. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Hey, he's obviously not seeing this guy at all right now. Two off-balance swings. He's going to have to battle.
Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the tower like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
Swung on in the dirt, strike three. And he makes the throw to first. Garland is retired, two down now. Base is empty, two away. And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder, Byron Buxton. No score here as we play inning number two. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Another full count pitch home. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Twins are set down 1-2-3. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. The Astros designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. Ball to 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Here's a fly ball, well hit. A ball that's tearing. A leap, but it's off his glove. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard.
Well, this guy has proven he can make some athletic plays in the field, and he takes a decent route to the baseball here, but I'm not sure anybody is going to bring this one in. Ends up out of his reach and bangs up off the wall.
In now, Yuli Gurriel. Gurriel behind, a ball and 2 strikes.
One and two.
No one out with a runner at second. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. From the stretch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Buxton is there, and he has it for the first out.
Batting 7, the right fielder, Kyle Tucker.
One down with a runner at second, and in to hit next will be the outfielder, Kyle Tucker. No offer on that one, 2 balls and a strike.
Count 2 and 1.
Crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with 2 strikes.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt, but he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Hard hit ball to second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. He'll come home with it. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, Beeler. Get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Blake now. Miles Strong in the dirt here. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. Runner at second here with one man out. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Jason Castro is on deck. Timing just a tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Two pitch, and it's fouled away, making him sweat out there. The 7th pitch coming up. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run. two-run shot to left center, and the Astros have taken a 3-0 lead.
Man, you could see the center fielder tracking the ball the entire way. He thought he had it, and he might tell you he should have had it, but he just couldn't bring it back into the yard. Sometimes it's a game of inches, folks.
Stepping in now, Jason Castro. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task at hand. And right now, he needs to think about this hitter.
The 2-1 home. Popped him up. Donaldson is underneath this one, and that's out number two. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. He popped out in his first trip. Now the 2-1. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
Now a liner caught out there by Simmons. Pretty much right in the glove that time, and the inning is over. But they strike for three in the inning, two on this two-run home run. We've played two. It's now 3-0 Houston. Top of the third set to get underway, and now it'll be the catcher, Ryan Jeffers.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
The 1-1.
Count will do it away.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence, he's got great body language on the mound, he's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Altuve, stay with it as he backs up and puts it away, one gone. One away, and here's the shortstop, Andrelton Simmons. Here it's now 2-2 to the Minnesota shortstop.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off speed pitch in the dirt.
He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
Plate, Max Kepler, fouled away. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Pulled in the air out into right field. Tucker is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back. Into the box. Luis Arraez. Popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
High in the air out to center field. Strong will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Twins wind up stranding one. They trail it here 3-0. And we're back for the bottom of the third. Let's check Andy Watney.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros' offense with Houston's manager, and he was very pleased with how little they're swinging and missing right now. We looked into the numbers, and as a team, they've had a contact rate of over 85% in this game, meaning that when they swing the bat, they're missing the ball less than 15% of the time. To put that into context, the very best teams in baseball usually are right around 80% for an entire season. So at least for today, they're displaying an amazing ability to put wood to ball.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Bounce towards the mound. And there's one away. So one out and nobody aboard. And that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Michael Brantley. Second, scooped up, and he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. So here's the cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Matty, almost his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
You know, what I'm seeing here is a reluctance to throw the fastball. It's like he feels he can't throw the ball right by him right now.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. Kepler is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Astros go down 1-2-3. They lead it 3-0. Start of the fourth, and standing in is the veteran third baseman Josh Donaldson. 3-1 now. And now a soft liner to the left side, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. Full count still.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Now Josh Donaldson becomes the first out of the inning. Now, Nelson Cruz. Ball four.
Well, he loses them there, but that's just the first walk he's given up, along with a couple of hits, so his command has been pretty solid so far.
Next up is Miguel Sano, struck out in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
The 1-2.
Ball. Down.
Swing and a high fly ball out to left field. Looking up is Brantley. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. Two runs on the board after that home run by Miguel Sano. And the Twins are back within a run. It's now a 3-2 ball game.
Well, they were a lot more comfortable up three than they are now, only up by one. That just goes to show you one pitch, one two-run shot, and the entire complexion of a game can change just like that.
Standing in now, Kyle Garland. And he fouls this one off. Two runs, three hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone.
It's never easy to rebound after serving up a two-run shot, but that at bat was a good indication to me that he isn't letting it get to him. He went right after him for the strikeout.
Baseman Gurriel, and that will end the inning. A two-run score for the Twins, both coming on this two-run home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Astros 3 and the Twins 2. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at-bat.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. So bases are empty with one gun. And digging into bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. The 1-1 home. Drilled right back up the middle. And into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in. Kept his hands inside the baseball, ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball is going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
So now to the plate, Kyle Tucker. Pitch outside, the throw. Not in time. Pretty close, but he got in there safely. Certainly a very close play at second on that bag, so let's analyze it with Showtrack. We all know he's got plus speed on his side, and you really see it represented in the top speed. That really made the difference on that one. On a good pitch there, had a correction to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
Hey, don't kid yourself. I know those were two bad swings, but he hits middle of the order for a reason. It only takes one swing.
Still 2-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
Well, I think this is the kind of approach they need against such a prolific starter. You can't count on putting up a lot of runs, so getting him out of the game has to be the priority. Working at bats, full counts, running up the pitch count is a great way of doing that.
Throw just in time as he was flying down the line that time. And now in the box, Miles Straw, runner in scoring position with Sugan. We're in the fourth. 3-2 is our score. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Yeah, and that splitter is normally the go-to pitch to this guy, but it really hasn't shown that good downward action that he usually has. He needs to get back to finishing it out front.
Two and one, here it is. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now, 3-1.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
Full count now, 3-2. He sent the payoff pitch. Line drive to left. Garland is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble for Houston, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Now to the plate, Ryan Jeffers. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. This one's down to third. Bregman has it. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Up next for Minnesota,
Andrelton Simmons. He singled first time up.
Fifth inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. The 3-2 one more time. Hit back up the middle. And there are two away now.
Up next to the plate.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Max Kepler, 0 for 2 on his line thus far. The 2-1.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Line toward the gap in left center. That gets down, and the inning will continue. And this will get all the way to the wall now. And he will pull into second with a two-out double.
Hey, guys, he doubled up on that breaking ball. The batter obviously timed the first one. Second one, he was not going to let go. Good wood on that one, able to drive it for a base hit.
Into the box now, Luis Arraez. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1. Josh Donaldson would be next. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Base hit, line drive into the corner. He pulls into second safely as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game.
Well, he was almost out of the inning. Did the last two batters show him that you can't lose focus on the mound, even if you get two quick outs? Back-to-back doubles shows you just how quickly things can get away from you.
Now here comes the Houston manager out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And a change is forthcoming, as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. So he'll depart in the fifth with the go-ahead run on base. Didn't work the required five for the win, but he could still be hung for the loss should that run come around to score. Pedro Baez, a right-hander standing 6 foot even, will take over the pitching duties here.
Number 52, Pedro Baez.
At the plate, Josh Donaldson. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. And another foul ball. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. A run for the Twins, and it comes on this RBI double. Middle of the night now for Memorial Park, and we are all tied at 3 apiece. Ready now is Jason Castro. Flew out in his only at-bat so far.
Line shot to first, and there's one away.
Now back, second baseman.
Up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Tough to do much with that one, a swing and a miss.
Not too many guys taking the mound today with this good a split. Look at the downward action on that thing. It's falling off the table.
And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now. Next to stand in is Alex Bregman, grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Here's the 1-2 delivery.
At the ball.
Wow, that was a close pitch on 1-2. The count's now at 2-2, but boy, that one very easily could have been called strike three. Really close pitch.
Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there.
Well, the 1-2 pitch didn't go his way, and now a miss there on 2-2. You know he doesn't want this at bat to get away from, so I think we're going to see a challenge pitch on a full count.
Up the middle. That's through, and he's got his first base hit. He's 1-for-3.
Hey, D-Roll, that's just what you want to do. Keep the pressure on. He's given up a couple of runs early already in this game, and now he gives up the two-out single.
Yeah, no chance right there. You want to make this guy work. You want to try and get into their pen as quick as possible, and if two-out knocks are the answer, then so be it.
At the plate now, Michael Brantley. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
He's got to find a way to grab some composure out there and not let this inning get away from him. He was dominating, and now he goes out and gives up a two-out single and then almost drills a guy. Get back in the zone.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
That's a good job right there. You very rarely see pitchers double up where they go a pitch inside. Normally, they'll go back outside, but he followed that up with another pitch on the inside part of the plate.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Grounded back up the middle. Reined in. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first. Saves an error as the side is retired. Astros leave one. Five innings complete. All tied 3-3. The number 4 Minnesota hitter, Nelson Cruz, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
Standing in now, Miguel Sano. Two-ball, one-strike count to the Twins' first baseman. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 2-1 pitch. Breaking ball well inside and taken for ball three. Kyle Garlick waits on deck. Strike two, swinging just out in front of the slider. One out, nobody on. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Now batting, the left fielder, Kyle.
Next, it'll be Kyle Garlick. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. has a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
A couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Brantley on the move. He gets there, and that's the second out. So that'll bring in Byron Buxton. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Runner on first, two away, all tied at three apiece. Hit hard up the middle. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Now back, the catcher, Ryan Jeffers.
To the plate now, Ryan Jeffers, fouled off.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Here's the 1-2. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Twin strand a pair. On to the bottom of inning number six. Tied three apiece. Matt Shoemaker enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 32, Matt Shoemaker.
Here's Carlos Correa now. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. A 1-1.
Ball.
Bobby Cox always used to say, "I'm going to put you in positions to be successful." Well, against the modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
All even now, 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. So a full count now. Yordan Alvarez waits on deck. Two pitch. Correa, left field and carrying well. Looking up is the left fielder, and this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. It's a solo shot here for Carlos Correa as they take the lead 4-3.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
And now, Yordan Alvarez. And it misses, 3-1 now. Four runs, seven hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Now this ball's hit deep to left field. Left fielder looking up at the track, the wall, and that one is gone! A solo shot here to left, his fourth long ball of this series, and it's now 5-3.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
So now to the plate, Yuli Gurriel. Lined into right, a base hit.
Hey, they weren't going to keep this guy down for long. That's the ebbs and flows of the baseball season. Bottom line is, this guy has bat-to-ball skills. You knew he was going to get hot eventually.
Into the box, Kyle Tucker. On the ground to second base. This could be two. Simmons on to first, and they get the double play.
That's not the guy you're going to see doubled out very often, so that was a quick turn at second base. Good transfer and a strong throw.
Miles Straw will dig in again, and as he does, we'll flash you back to inning number two as you get a look at his two-run homer that was a big blow early on. Out, nobody on. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short, and Simmons will make the play here to retire the side. So two runs come across here, both coming via the solo home run. We're on to the seventh inning now in the deciding game five. It's the Astros 5 and the Twins 3. Blake Taylor is on to pitch from the ball to start inning number 7.
Number 62.
Now at the plate, Andrelton Simmons. A hit in two tries so far. Fouled away. This one's down to third. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7.
Now back. Right
now at the plate, here is Max Kepler. He's got a hit in 3 at bats to this point. Set and the 2-1 pitch.
Whoa,
too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Bases are empty, one man out. Fouled away.
Hey, 3 foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. And there's out number 2. Next, it'll be Luis Arraez. It was an RBI double for him in his last turn to the plate.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get. Maybe once an AB, maybe once.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Down go the Twins in order. They're still down 5-3. Hansel Robles will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the 7th.
For the Twins. Number 57, Hansel.
Stepping up is Jason Castro. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. The 1-1. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. Around first is Castro, heading for second now. And the Astros get something started right away. It's a leadoff double. Not every day that you see a ball come off the bat like that one did. And looking at it again on show track, we see it a lot faster than it came in. 113 miles an hour. Couldn't have hit that one much better than that. the plate, Jose Altuve. And this is down at the knees, but called a strike. Wow, it's 3-2 now. Not quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. Payoff pitch one more time. And he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Third baseman number two. Allen.
So it's first and second now. Nobody out. And that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And this is going to get down for extra bases as that'll get one, if not both of them, home. And the runner is in from second. And he's in safely at third as two runs come across to score away from the play.
That's the difference between average and good hitters. Good hitters almost always take advantage of RBI opportunities when they present themselves. He does it here, and the lead is now four.
Cody Stasiak comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number seven. Standing in now, Michael Brantley. Now a swing and a ball popped in the air back behind short. There to look it in is Simmons, one away. Carlos Correa will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Hit back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. Throw will be the first for the second out, but meanwhile, another run is in to score.
Two runs already home, and now you can make it three. Good job right there of keeping it simple and putting the ball in play.
Next will be the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. Catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1. Yuli Gurriel would be next. Three runs already home here. Pulled toward right center field. Buxton is camped under this one, and he will put it away to retire the side. So they pick up three runs on only two hits in the inning. No errors and no one left on base. We'll look ahead to inning number eight now. Houston leads this one 8-3. Joe Smith has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 38. Joe Smith.
Josh Donaldson digging in now. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Ground ball left side. Defense set up perfectly. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Here's Nelson Cruz now. 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far. Set to deliver on 2-1.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
The 3-1 pitch. High and deep down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. And this is Swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number eight.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next, and they're down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, that's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
And he fouls this one off. Here's the 1-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Twins are set down 1-2-3. Can't make any headway into an 8-3 deficit. Randy Dobnik is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number Randy Dobnik.
Bottom of inning number eight set to go. And digging in to bat next, the Cuban import Yuli Gurriel. The 1-1. Hit on the ground down the first baseline.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it at one position, and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off the table and chasing your hands.
Got him to chase out of the zone that time. Yuli Gurriel becomes the first out in the bottom of the eighth inning. Stepping in now, Kyle Tucker. Opposite field to left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out.
Now batting, number three.
Striding in for Houston, Miles Straw. The 1-1. Two out, nobody on. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Again, he sends it out of play. Again, a 1-2. Now a ball hit towards Simmons at short. He's right there. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Astros, but they lead it by a count of 8-3. Steve Cishek comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Steve Cishek.
So kicking off the top of the ninth is Kyle Garlick, and they could use a spark from him here. Now the 2-1. Wheatley hit to third. Bregman gloves it. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Now the numbers head to head with Steve Cishek. He's 0-for-5. One out, nobody on. And he lays off. It's an even the count, 2-2.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off
off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Here's the 2-2 pitch. Swung on by Buxton, and this is sent to deep left field. Solo home run for Byron Buxton, as it is now an 8-4 ball game. Now Ryan Jeffers hit in the air down the right field line. On the run is Tucker. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. That will be Andrelton Simmons, and their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out. Bases are empty here with two men out. Line toward right center. That gets down, and the inning continues.
Outside of home runs, nothing fires me up more than watching a good baseball player drive the ball to the opposite field. Talking about hitting the inside half of the baseball, that's exactly what happened right there. And when we say inside half of the baseball, imagine the ball coming to a complete stop halfway between home plate and the pitcher's mound, and then cutting that baseball in half and highlighting the inside half. That's where you're trying to take the knob of your bat or the hands to that spot and carve the inside half of the baseball with power.
Brooks Raley hits the call here as he'll try and look for one out to finish this thing off. In now, Max Kepler, 2-1 now to the Twins' leadoff man. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
The 3-1 pitch. And this is swung on and missed. So now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. He struck him out, and that'll do it as they've won this series, so they'll move on.
Well, they know their work is nowhere close to being finished, but they've handled their business so far, winning here to punch their ticket to the next round and a possible trip to the World Series. Well done.
For the left-hander Dan Plesac, Mark DeRosa, and our entire crew, this is Matt Vasgersian. This has been the American League Division Series.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 8 runs on 11 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base. For the Twins, 4 runs on 8 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 26 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.